In this video, we describe an analytic unification of two actions frequently used in graph reduction. The deletion of edges, often used in graph sparsification algorithms, and the contraction of edges, that is, the merging of two adjacent nodes, which is often used in graph coarsening algorithms.
Prior to this work, sparsification and coarsening were treated as separate algorithmic primitives with different objective functions. What we're seeing now is our graph reduction algorithm in action, which uses this analytic unification to simultaneously sparsify and coarsen a graph.
The actions of edge deletion and edge contraction are in fact dual operations.
One manifestation of this duality is seen by considering a planar graph shown here in blue.
The planar dual of this graph, shown here in red, is created by first placing its red vertices in the regions formed by the planar embedding of the original graph.
Then one adds a red edge between each of these red vertices that share a blue border. Notice that the planar dual always has the same number of edges as the original graph, such that each edge in one graph crosses exactly one edge in the other graph.
Now, if one of the blue edges is deleted, its corresponding red edge is contracted, merging the two red nodes into one. Likewise, if a blue edge were to be contracted, it would amount to deleting its corresponding red edge.
This duality generalizes to non-planar graphs by considering its associated graphic matroid and its dual.
Algebraically, this duality is reflected in the graph Laplacian, a matrix operator related to diffusion throughout a graph, and whose spectrum reveals information about the graph's global structure.
Indeed, many sparsification and coarsening algorithms aim to preserve properties associated with the graph Laplacian.
Consider the heat equation, a prototypical diffusive process. With respect to the dynamics of this differential equation, edge deletion corresponds to the limit of zero edge weight, while edge contraction corresponds to the limit of infinite edge weight. However, this edge contraction limit requires some entries in the graph Laplacian to become infinite, making analytic treatment difficult. Our primary insight came from the fact that the inverse of the graph Laplacian remains finite in both of these limits.
And in fact, many relevant problems on graphs involve solving the equation Lx equals b for x. So, the solution is given by applying the inverse to b.
Moreover, while the lowest eigenvalues of the Laplacian are associated with the graph's global structure, by inverting the spectrum, these correspond to the highest eigenvalues of the inverse Laplacian.
Motivated by these considerations, we developed a probabilistic graph reduction algorithm that preserves the inverse Laplacian in expectation and aims to minimize the expected square error for a given amount of reduction.
Thus, by preserving the inverse Laplacian, our algorithm is able to perform both edge deletion and edge contraction, while preferentially retaining the large-scale structure of a graph. If this video piqued your interest, please stop by our poster, Wednesday from 5 to 7 p.m. in East Exhibition Hall B and C. Thanks for watching.